More and more people are coming to know who he is. He is rampant. I know you've heard of him. Who hasn't? You must know of how he takes aunties and uncles and mummies and daddies and make their bodies more trees, arranging trick cells to turn on your body and build homes in vital organs. He makes homes in vital organs. Imagine. I find myself in the mirror every morning as a mandate to check my bosoms just to make sure he didn't start squatting in tissues without permission. He likes to be called tumor sometimes. I prefer the name malignant immigrant, and I don't want a mastectomy. I learn how he comes like a thief in the night and takes away everything in an instant. You think Frank who are scary? What is scary is how he's just sitting there waiting for an opportunity to show up and make a mess in the form of a mask. They can't smoke or gain too much weight or sit down on your behind for too long without exercise before he takes it as an open invitation. I promise, this is not a monster you want to come in contact with. You think Texas Chainsaw Massacre is scary? My friend told me about a monster that saw his mother's foot off. He said she had been fighting his attacks and hacks for years until her body became weak and her feet gave away in blood. And here he goes by the name of diabetes. I hear the old people who know him better call him sugar. So stay away from sugar. Stay away from the sugar as much as it can. It tastes good, but does the most amount of damage. And notice your smile disappear when he's here. And notice your mouth and your eyes droop down on your left side. And notice how you're scared, stiff on your left side and can't move. And notice how your speech slurred, as if he threatened you to not make a certain sound or else you will succumb to his insolent ways. You think he can't demand something to be afraid of? When you stand in the mirror at midnight, about to call his name 3 times to see if he appears, or if you real or not, acknowledge the face of the monster in the mirror. Acknowledge how he tricks in himself into self-harm by making himself physically sick with worry or stress until he becomes depressed. Look at how his bad habits and his inability to take responsibility for his actions cascade like blinds and wrongs him with chains. And the worst of the worst is when he's unable to find balance. So it is angry all the time. You see, monster is angry and anxious all the time and picks fights over peace all the time. Or maybe there are monsters that take your breath away, that stops your heart from beating. The ones that pile in your arteries with placards as if in protest against the guilty pleasures you like to indulge in. The monsters that are deep fried and delicious. The over-the-counter monsters. The stray from the car monsters, the monsters that mask themselves in the neglect or lack of self-management, the 4 shot glasses on a bar counter every Friday night monsters. Don't care if it's a big person, or doesn't care about your career, or that you have 5 kids, and a husband, and a wife, that you just finished school, and have your entire life ahead of you. If you don't take care of yourself now and be vigilant of these monsters, who will? I heard prevention is better than cure. I heard the monsters hate the taste of locally grown foods and vegetables and fruits. I heard the words green and leafy makes them sick to their stomach and stops them in their tracks. I heard that regular exercise and sweating from workout baptizes them in the name of healthier life. They don't like that. I heard taking care of yourself is how to keep them away. I started by saying that the monsters that we're supposed to be afraid of aren't hiding under our beds or lurking in the shadows like we're told. They're right in front of us with their hands outstretched waving hello, not trying to be secrets. See, we are the monsters. And look at how we're destroying ourselves with our hands, with our hearts, with the food we eat, with the thoughts we think, with the way we treat people, and the people we choose to love. Let us water the gardens that are our bodies with goodness, and watch flowers spring from our bones. Let us smile and have good relationships with each other, and watch the flowers erupt from our souls. We are the monsters we should be afraid of, but I know that we're also everything we need.